Hello friends, in this video we will solve a problem to analyze the time complexity for a recursive function. So this is t of n equals to 3 times t of n by 4 plus theta of n square. So first of all, let me clear what is the meaning of this question. It means t of n means time taken by the function for input value n, time for input value n. Now this is a recursion function, so basically the function will call itself with different input. So it means this function will divide into this. What is the meaning of this? This means 3 times t of n by 4. It means the function will break down into three parts with input n by 4. If n is the initial input, then at each level the input will be n by 4 when the function will break down into three parts. And this theta of n square means the time taken to combine all these parts is a function of n square, so it will be constant c n square. If input is n, then this time is n square. If input is n by 2, then the time will be n by 2 whole square, like this. So this is the meaning of this question. Now we are going to solve it. So t of n, this will break down into three parts with input n by 4, t of n by 4. Now each part will again break down into three parts, but this time the input will be 1/4 of this input, because we are considering this as a individual function. So t n by 4 square, because we have multiplied it by 1 by 4 again. So t of n by 4 square, t of n by 4 square. Similarly, this will break down into 3 parts and each part will be same, t of n by 4 square. Similarly, this will break down into 3 parts. Now again, this will break down into 3 parts. This will again divide it into 3 parts. This also 3 parts. And likewise, this will also be divided into 3 parts with the input 1 by 4th of this input, means this will become like n by 4 cube. So let us assume that we have total i levels, and at ith level the input will be 1. So this is our first level, this is our second level, this is our third level, likewise this will be our ith level. So if we see the pattern here, input is this, we are considering it as 0th level. So here input is n by 4 power 1. This is first level 1, this is second level. So input is n by 4 square, level is 1, power is 1, level is 2, power is 2. Likewise here level is I, so input will be n by 4 to the power I, this is equals to 1. So by this we can solve that how many levels be there in the function when it will break down. Now time, we will calculate time. So t of n, so when input is n, time is as a function of n, that is n square, so c into n square. Now when the input is n by 4, the time will be c into n by 4 whole square. Input is n by 4, so time will be as a function of n by 4 itself, so it will be c into n by 4 whole square. And we have 3 parts here, so it will be multiplied by 3. This is our first level. At second level we will be having 9 parts, 3 parts for each of these 3 parts. So 9 into C into input is n by 4 square. So it's whole square because theta n square. So input is n, then n square, input is n by 4 square, then time will be n by 4 square whole square. So likewise, if we see the pattern, then it comes like this is level 1, this is 3 to the power 1, and this is, if we solve it, it will become 3 power 1 c into n square. This we take as c n square divided by, it will be 16 to the power 1. So this is for level 1. So likewise, it will be 3 c n square divided by 16, this is 16 whole square, and this is 9 is 3 whole square. So if we see the pattern here, so for ith level it will become the total time taken to combine all the parts will become 3 to the power I divided by 16 to the power I into c n square. So this is the time taken to combine all the parts at the ith level. So now total time t of n, this is equals to, since we have got a generalized form for each level, so we will use sigma I runs from 0, or you can say this is k runs from 0 to I, since last level is I, and this is 3 to the power k divided by 16 to the power k into c n square. So this is the total time taken. Now c n square, we take it as common, it is constant, sigma k equals to 0 to k equals to I, this becomes 3 by 16 whole power k. So as the value of k increases, this decreases, and this is a geometric series. So we are taking the limits from 0 to infinite. In finite, we are taking the limits, so it will be easy to calculate its sum, and it comes out to be a by 1 minus r, a is 3 by 16. Sorry, it is 1 a by 1 minus r, okay. So for the 0th level, we can consider this as 1 only. 0th level it will be 1, k value 0, so it will be 1. So a is 1 divided by 1 minus r, r is 3 by 16. So it will become 16 will go up, and this is 13. So we get 16 by 13 when we take the limit from 0 to infinite. So 16 by 13 is also a constant. So the total time taken is c n square into 16 by 3, 13. So this is a constant, this is a constant. So we can write as a c n square, total time taken by the recursion function. And we can also calculate the number of levels, since this is input is 1, input size equals to 1, and n by 4 to the power I, this becomes n equals to 4 to the power I, and when we take log on both sides, log n becomes log 4 to the power I. If we take the base 4, then it becomes I. So I is equals to log n base 4, number of levels, and this is the total time c n square. So this was the method recursion tree. In next video, we will solve these problems using Master's theorem without proof. Thanks for watching. I hope you understand the concept.